Okay, moving on to the carpals. We're going to use our mnemonic. Some lovers try positions that they can't handle. And we actually have a left hand. So remember that for that mnemonic, we always work proximal to distal. And remember that we start thumb side because we work lateral to medial. Remembering that in anatomical position, the thumb is lateral. So we start with the bone that is closest to the radius, and that would be some lovers try positions. So for the first row, these two bones are actually stacked, so you've got one on top of the other. So we have some lovers try positions, which is scaphoid, lunate, triquetrum, pisiform. Then we go back to the thumb. That they can't handle. So we have that they can't handle. Trapezium is under the thumb. It rhymes. They is trapezoid. Can't, capitate. Handle is hamate. So we've got some lovers try positions. Positions is on top. That they can't handle. Scaphoid, lunate, triquetrum, pisiform. Let me go back to the thumb. Trapezium is under the thumb. It rhymes. Trapezium, trapezoid, capitate, hamate. Hamate has a hook. You can feel the hook with your fingers. So, scaphoid, lunate, triquetrum, pisiform, trapezium, trapezoid, capitate, hamate. Some lovers try positions that they can't handle. Now, as we go farther distally from the carpals, which remember are short bones, we have our long bones, including the first metacarpal, second metacarpal, third metacarpal, fourth metacarpal, fifth metacarpal. Then we have our phalanges. We have our proximal and distal phalanx in the thumb. Proximal, middle, and distal phalanges in all of the other fingers. So if we were to tag this bone for your midterm, this would be the second metacarpal. If we were to tag this bone for your midterm, it would be the middle phalanx of the fourth digit. Because just like our metacarpals are first, second, third, fourth, and fifth, we have our first, second, third, fourth, and fifth digits are your fingers. Now, if you were to have the opposite hand, remember to work with the mnemonic for the carpals, starting from the radius and proximal first, and you work proximal to distal, medial to lateral. The radius is more expanded than the ulna. So you always start from this bigger bone. That's your radius. Or you could look at it from the thumb side. So it works the same for both hands. You just have to make sure you start on the correct side.